Supreme Court Justice Ketanji Jackson, or Brown Jackson, has been sworn in, making history as the first female African-American to hold the post. In a statement following her oath-taking, Jackson said she will support and defend the U.S. Constitution and administer justice without fear or favor. But she is joining a court in turmoil. The country is still reeling from the aftermath of the court's most consequential rulings in decades, the overturning of abortion rights, the expansion of gun rights, and now limiting the government's power to curb carbon emissions. In other news, Chinese President Xi Jinping makes his first visit to Hong Kong in about 3 years. Xi arrived at the Special Administrative Region on Thursday, where he met with Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam and other officials ahead of the 25th anniversary of the city's return to Chinese rule. He is expected to lead the celebrations today, Friday, and inaugurate Hong Kong's new government. The move is seen to showcase the Chinese Communist Party's power over the business hub, 3 years after it unleashed a harsh crackdown on pro-democracy protesters. Xi claims Hong Kong has been reborn, and with the one country, two systems policy firmly in place, its future will be better. The Philippines joins 25 other countries in the biennial rim of the Pacific drills. It's deemed as the world's largest international maritime exercise. The BRP Antonio Luna, a guided missile frigate, will be participating on behalf of the Philippine Navy. The U.S. Navy says the drills will give participating countries the opportunity to refine individual and combined maritime abilities and will help promote a free and open Indo-Pacific. The maritime drills will be conducted in and around the Hawaiian Islands and Southern California until August 4. It comes amid China's rising influence and aggression in the West Philippine Sea. OPEC and its allies stick to a planned output increase in August, defying calls to pump more barrels to cool crude prices. The group will increase monthly overall production for August to 648,000 barrels per day. OPEC Plus has been slowly returning the nearly 10 million barrels per day it pulled from the market in April 2020 when the pandemic hit demand. Oil prices slipped on Thursday after OPEC's decision and amid concerns about the global supply tightness. International benchmark Brent crude fell to $114 a barrel, while U.S. crude settled at $108. The Philippine Central Bank sees inflation accelerating further in June. The BSP expects the Consumer Price Index to settle within the range of 5.7 to 6.5%. That's way above government's target range of 2 to 4% and even higher than the 5.4% inflation recorded in May. The BSP cites the continued increase in oil and power prices and the peso's depreciation as primary sources of inflationary pressures for the month. Central Bank has raised its benchmark interest rate twice this year to 2.5% in a bid to tame inflation. Switching gears now, Natalie Portman celebrates female strength as she stars in Thor: Love and Thunder. Yong Chavez tells us more about some of the characters in the latest Marvel film to hit the big screen.
As an actress, Oscar winner Natalie Portman relishes the chance to transform and play various characters. For Thor: Love and Thunder, her physical preparations began months before the cameras rolled so she could return to the Marvel film franchise as Jane Foster, now also known as the Mighty Thor.
It's so exciting to get to play a character like Jane. I feel so lucky to get to be, get to be a superhero. That's like such an extraordinary opportunity, and I feel so lucky to have had the chance. And Jane is also such an incredible character as an astrophysicist. I feel like that's exciting to get to represent to girls.
Her co-star Tessa Thompson celebrated Portman's and the Thor's cast's return on the big screen. Thompson also shared what it meant for her to be part of a big Hollywood film.
Natalie rejoining us. She's a good friend of mine, so having her felt like summer camp. The last time around, they were a little more freewheeling. This time, they're like, you know, Thor is having a midlife crisis. Valkyrie has finally turned herself around and is a, you know, a woman of bureaucracy and responsibility. And so it's fun to play these characters that we love so much and see them grow as we grow too. I grew up in Los Angeles. I used to come to movies here. My dad would take me to this cinema, and it was always like a big deal when I got to see movies here. So I can't believe I am now in movies here.
The film recently held its star-studded world premiere in Hollywood, led by Thor himself, Chris Hemsworth. The latest Marvel movie also stars film actor Dave Bautista, who appears as his Guardians of the Galaxy character, Drax.
Thor: Love and Thunder is directed by Taika Waititi, who also returns in the movie as Korg. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.